The Brockville Museum acknowledges the land on which we gather to exchange ideas and share our past, present, and future is the traditional territory of the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, and Wendat people. Looking around Brockville, it's easy to find many old buildings, if you know where to look. And if you look closely, you might find some interesting bits of architecture. Welcome to the Brockville Museum's Building Brockville series. Well, we will explore some of the different architectural styles that can be found around the city. Today, we are looking at Gothic Revival and Romanesque architecture styles, and these were popular from the mid to late 1800s. This style became massively popular in Ontario during the mid to late 1800s as the favorite design for churches, and it peaks right about the same time that a lot of Ontario's earliest European settled communities are booming, so it also becomes a means of showing wealth and stature. To this day, many Christian religion groups still associate the Gothic aesthetic with their places of worship, to the point that it's common to find many modernly built buildings with Gothic architecture. In Brockville, many of the older churches were designed in the Gothic Revival architectural style. And if you stand here on the courthouse green and look around at these churches, you can see many common features. One of the hallmarks of the Gothic Revival style is exaggerating and emphasizing the height of buildings. To do this, churches were built very tall with steeply pitched roofs and long, slender spires. Height was also exaggerated by using arched windows and doorways that you can see on many of these churches. And on the windows, many of them are tracery windows, which is a very common style for these buildings. And it's when a window is divided up into different segments using ribs of carved stone or even metal. Now, these steep roofs and very thick stone walls were also considered to be perfect for the cold Canadian climate. Many historic buildings still standing in Brockville were designed by local architect Thomas Fuller, whose Toronto-based firm specialized in Gothic Revival style. In Brockville, the old post office was designed to be a great example of how he often blended Gothic Revival and Romanesque styles together. And it's seen here in the building that we have behind us. It has the Romanesque features of a deep-set arched doorway with decorated extratos, which are the outer edges of the arches, which are often very, very decorative. And it has large rectangular windows with heavy transoms, which are the decorated horizontal pieces along windows and doors to separate floors. Was influential in creating a defining character for the federal architecture of Canada. He and partner Chilian Jones also designed the first Gothic Revival Parliament buildings in Ottawa in 1859, and in 1881 Fuller became the Dominion Chief Architect and supervised the design and building of over 140 buildings across the country. So often Gothic Revival is mixed with the Romanesque style, and they share many similarities. The Romanesque style is often used to build massive government buildings because of its imposing style, which we can see with the Brockville Armouries behind me here. This style often feels very heavy due to its size, the stone materials it's used, and general design, which is often fairly low feeling to the ground. You also often have things like rounded towers that have crenulations or battlements on top of it. Also, to add to all this, you use rough stone to create a more rustic feel. When classifying architecture, particularly in rural areas and small towns, it can be difficult because the buildings can be a mix of various styles, particularly when additions and renovations occur over the years. Styles didn't change overnight, and often you'll see an overlap of these styles as tastes begin to change. And sometimes even the experts have difficulty telling what a building should be classified as. If you're interested in some of the terms that we use today, make sure to check out our architectural terms list in the link down below. And there are many different Gothic Revival and Romanesque buildings around Brockville, so if you decide to go and investigate for yourself, take a look around, but please be mindful of private property. Thank you for joining us as we explore Brockville architecture, and next time you're walking around your neighborhood, take a look around, because you never know what you might see.